Hi everyone, and today we are gonna see the SQL Island. This is the game developed by the university professors in order to help the students to learn SQL by playing the game. In academia it's called the gamification, so you are kind of playing the game while learning something. Let's start. In order to start, first let's change the language. Need to click on the Sprache wechseln and then there are three languages available. We're gonna choose the English. So let's go. After surviving a plane crash, you will be stuck on SQL Island for the time being. By making progress in the game, you'll find a way to escape from this island. That's funny. It reminds me of the Lost. Do you remember the Lost? So in the Lost, like, do you remember you got the in the island and there was no one and you had to search for someone and so on? This field is where you write your commands. The complete game will be controlled by means of the database language SQL. All right, you don't know anything about SQL. Okay, I know something. If you don't know, down here you'll find the tables. Here there are tables, and in the bracket there are information about them. Okay, in case you want to restart the game or replay the game instruction, just click on this menu button. Game instructions, restart game, and so on. Why it's in German still? Anyways. Oh dear, what happened? It seems that I'm the only survivor of the crash, air crash. Wow, there are some islands, village on the island. So it's example, it's how it's gonna be like working like. It's normal SQL, select everything from the village. There are three villages. This village has 13 chiefs. Like Monkey City, they have one chief. The Cucumber Town have 6 chiefs. Right, let's go. It seems there are few people living in the villages. How can I see a list of inhabitants? So as they told us before, there's a, here we have inhabitants table, and we can select. So it's saying that how can I see the list of inhabitants? Also, let's say I want to see the name of the people who are living in this inhabitant. Let's go submit. No such column name. Oh my god, I forgot the from. The columns are wrong. Well, probably they have given the constraint that until you're not getting the certain output, the mission is not passed. Let's see everything from the inhabitant. All right, cool. Now we can go to the next one. So many people. Oh my god. I'm hungry. I will go and find butcher to ask for free sausages. Free sausages. I will go to that island too. Select inhabitant. Alright, and every inhabitant has its. Okay, it's over the plate. Where you are? There you are. Enjoy your meal, but take care of yourself. As long as you're unarmed, stay away from villains. Not everyone on this island is friendly. Alright, cool. Got it. He's eating his sausage Brustel. Thank you, Edward. Okay, let's see who's friendly on this island. There's a state, friendly, evil, and so on. And I'm gonna use the verb. State is evil. I'm not sure is it case sensitive or not. But anyways, so we are checking for the friendly, not evil. Let's see. Evil. Are case sensitive. Oh, there's also kidnapped. Alright, let's do it next. That's case sensitive. Sorry, I just sneezed. Friendly. Probably it wants me to write in a certain way. Instead of skipping the part. Alright, it wants me to write a certain way the query. Alright, let's go. Thank you, Edward. It's friendly on this. I see who's friendly on this island. These guys are friendly guys. I wanna be a friend with them. There's no way around getting a sword for myself. I will now try to find a friendly weaponsmith to forge me one. Oh my god. You can quite predict it in the end. Okay, friendly and. Chop. Want the job to be the Weapon smith. How many weapon smith do we have? Anyways. Weapon smith. Ah, there's only one weapon smith. Oh my god. Village ID. Gold. Friendly. There's no way around to get into the sword myself. Alright, I found him. Then? Okay. Doesn't look good. Maybe other friendly smith can help you. That doesn't look. Why it doesn't look good? Smith, one inhabitant who ends with Smith is a wild card or any number of characters. Where job. Is like Smith. Let me see whether it's gonna work. Yeah, okay. I forgot about is. So it's found. That looks better. So we have different smiths here, blacksmith, smith, and so on. That's cool. Let's continue. Hi, stranger. Where are you going? I'm Paul. I'm the mayor of Monkey City. I'll go ahead and register you as a citizen. Ha! I'm becoming a citizen. That's not much easy. I won't go to that island. So what it asks me? Insert into inhabitant. Ah, so he inserted me, stranger. I'm a stranger. Cool. I'm a stranger. And name village ID 1. I became the ID 1 because I came to the Peter. No. Or at Monkey City, it's gonna be Peter. All right. Continue. No need to call me a stranger. That's what I was thinking. Why I'm a stranger? I have my name. What's my personal ID? Informal credits data stands for all columns, and you can also address one or more columns. That's what I was trying to do, by the way, at the beginning of the of this task. Anyways, and you will only get the columns you need. So ID is one, right? Village ID and name. Where's ID? What I should do? Like, where's the question, by the way? And informal credits. Columns you need. What's my personal ID? Oh, right, all right, all right, cool. I need to find my personal ID. So it's from inhabitants. Their name. Right, and then name equal to stranger. Let me see, what's my personal ID? Ah, I don't need all of them, right? I need the personal ID. 20. Highness, how much is a sword? Let me see. I can offer to make you a sword for 150 gold. That's the cheapest you will find. How much gold do you have? How much gold do I have? Should I check my gold? Do I have the gold? Yeah, gold. I have 0 gold, so. What should I do? Should I choose the gold? Person ID equal to 20. I can offer to make you a sword for 100. What? I have 0 gold. Damn! No mon, no fun. No mon, no fun. There's been another option to earn gold other than going to work. Maybe I could collect ownerless items and sell them. Can I make a list of all items and so on? You can recognize ownerless items by where owner is now. Okay, cool. Where are the items? Ah, okay. So we are selecting the everything from item. Then we are at where owner is null. I'm just copying and passing it. Where owner is null. So much cool stuff, man! Alright, cool. Yay, a coffee cup. Let's collect it. Cool. Now I'm the owner of the coffee. What was the coffee cup? I don't know why I need the coffee cup, even though I don't have a mocha to make a coffee. Don't know how to collect all the ownerless items. A trick how to collect all the. Oh, so should I find a trick? So what should be the trick though to get like all the ownerless items? Items equal to item set. So I think that this is the trick. Instead of saying the items coffee cup, you're gonna say the owner is null. Is null. Let me see that, whether it works. Cool, that works. Do you know a trick how to collect all the owners? Oh yes, I do. Yes, we're updating the table where the owner is null. Now list all of the items I have. All the items that I have. So we're gonna select everything from item where owner is 20. Let me see. So guys, it's not it's diff it's there's no difference between writing the query like that or like this. It's not Python, so you're not required to have the indentation. So that's why it's kind of equal, like it's kind of the same if you're using like this or so on. Anyways, so that's the all the list of the but what are the price for them? Find a friend and who is either a dealer or merchant. Maybe they want to buy some of them. All right, let's go. So we're selecting from inhabitant, selecting everything from inhabitant. Right, for the next time, instead of writing a thing like that, we're just going to comment them item so we can use whenever we want to use it. And village from inhabitant. So inhabitant is a table where we have all the inhabitants where the job dealer or a merchant. So dealer or job is merchant. Oh, it's getting incomplete. Either a dealer or a merchant. So I found either a dealer or a merchant. What should I add? So friendly, the friendly inhabitant, because there's also evil inhabitant. All right, and state is equal to friendly. Let me see. I misspelled the friendly, I think. Where job is equal to order merchant and state is equal to friendly. I don't get what is the problem here. Let me just delete this part. Oh my god, that was the problem. The problem was about my god. The problem was because I left the commands. Never leave the